Runaikids.
Good morning, teacher.
Good morning, children. Children, do you know why sky appears blue?
No, ma'am.
Can you explain the appearance of red sky during sunrise and sunset?
No, ma'am. We don't know why it happened.
All the answer of the above questions is based on Raman effect, for that an Indian physicist, C.V. Raman, got Nobel Prize. Children, do you want to know what is the answer of the above questions?
Yes, ma'am.
Then please see the full video. Chandrasekhara Venkata Raman was born at Tiruchirappalli in southern India on November 7, 1888. He was an extraordinary student and got inheriting education of physics. His father was a lecturer in mathematics and physics. At the little age of 15 years, he graduated with first place and gold medal in physics from Presidency College, Madras. In 1907, he gained his master degree, obtaining the highest distinctions. Since at that time, a scientific career did not appear to present the best possibilities, Raman joined the Indian Finance Department in 1907 as an assistant accountant at Calcutta. There he spent his spare time at the laboratory of Indian Association for the Cultivation of Science, which was based on the Royal Institution of London. Here, he worked on the sound vibration of musical instruments. On the basis of his research and thesis, he gained a reputation as a scientist in India as well as in Europe. On the basis of his knowledge and research, Calcutta University appointed him as a professor of physics in 1917. In 1921, Raman got an opportunity to attend a conference of universities held at Oxford University, London. Aboard the ship, Raman had carried with him some simple optical equipments, including a pocket-sized spectroscope and a prism. While traveling from the ship, Raman observed the blue color of the Mediterranean Sea. He started to observe the Lord Rayleigh explanation about the blue color of seawater is just the reflection of light from the water. Raman was not satisfied with this explanation of Lord Rayleigh and started his experiment on the scattering effect of light on the ship with the help of prism when returning from England. Raman continued his research on the scattering effect of light after coming to India. Raman's dedication and perseverance led to the publication of his findings in prominent international journals such as Nature, the Philosophical Magazine, and Physics Review. His note published in Nature with the heading "The Color of the Sea" gave him a spotlight and fame in the field of science. He described the blue color of light due to the diffraction of the light by water molecule. The red color of sky during sunrise and sunset is also due to the diffraction of light by air molecules. In 28 February 1928, he discovered a radiation effect of light which is presently known as Raman effect.
In 1929, C.V. Raman was decorated with the title of Sir by British government.
Sir C.V. Raman was decorated with Nobel Prize in Physics for Raman effect in 1930, Franklin Medal in 1941, Bharat Ratna in 1954, Lenin Peace Prize in 1957. In India, National Science Day is celebrated every year on February 28th to pay tribute to Dr. C.V. Raman, whose groundbreaking work illuminated the world of physics. Now the question is, what is Raman effect? Raman effect is the change in the wavelength of light that occurs when a light beam is deflected by molecules. When a beam of light traverses a dust-free, transparent sample of a chemical compound, a small fraction of the light emerges in directions other than that of the incident beam. Most of the scattered light is of unchanged wavelength. A small part, however, has wavelengths different from that of the incident light. Its presence is a result of the Raman effect. The Raman effect is used in a variety of ways in our daily life. It is used in a spectroscopy to identify molecules, which has applications in medical diagnosis and forensic science. It is also used in chemical analysis, allowing scientists to identify the composition of a sample without destroying it.